Hello everyone, Catweazle here, welcome back to the channel and to Runebound, 3rd edition, The Ascendance of Margath, Episode 6. Right, here we are, and here's Terranoth. First things first, what I've done is I've moved down the tracker to Space 12, and as you can see, what you do when you get to Space 12 is you turn up all the adventure gems, so I've done that just to save a bit of time. All the adventure gems are turned over. Master Thorn is actually on a combat adventure gem, but he hadn't turned it over yet, so that is why it is upright. Okay, so there we are, ready for turn 12. Where is everybody? Well, we've got Master Thorn here in the Blackwing Swamp. As just mentioned, he's on an adventure gem, which you'll be looking to do. And we have got Lyssa here, who's in the Riverlands, moving south towards Mennara's Teeth. And there we are, all ready for turn 12. Just before I get on to turn 12, just a quickie. Had a really good idea from George, who mentioned about my problems and with teleport. Yes, teleport, I keep forgetting for Master Thorn. Well, he mentioned, he said, well, why don't you put a big sign behind where all his trophies are going to go? And if you just look up here in the top corner, there it is, teleport behind all his quest trophies. So hopefully I'll be able to remember that the next time he gets a trophy. If not, I'm just going to have to brand my forehead or something, but hopefully that'll work. So cheers for that, George. Right, let's get straight back to Master Thorn and to turn 12. And here we are with Master Thorn. So, his first two actions, I'm going to flip that over, and we are going to have a go with the combat deck. The reason he's doing this is it's the end of the first act. The monsters get this extra rune, like, during the second act to become epic, and as you can see, it's nasty, and he'll have no chance in the second act. Unless he buffs up considerably. So what we'll do is he stood on the token, so he may as well have a go at it, and he may as well have a go at it now because it's Act 1. So let's see what he gets. He gets a great dragon. Well, perhaps it wouldn't have made any difference after an enemy. Oh god. Oh, hang on, it's a lot worse than it sounds. It's only got 5 health, so we might have a chance. How can you have a dragon with 5 health? But anyway, right. Savage dragon. 1 surge claw. Remove all of our shield tokens. Well, that's not too bad. 2 surges. Deals 1 combat damage. If that is not blocked for the rest of the combat round, we'll take 1 damage after each of our combat actions. Oh, right. So basically, you'd be smouldering and still taking damage. It's like damage over time, I suppose, for the rest of that combat round. Reward for defeating it is gain 2 gold or 1 lore. Right, so let's see if we can do him. Let's see if we can do him. At least it's only got 5 health. Right. So 5 tokens for the dragon, 3 tokens for Master Thorn. Let's see. Right, the dragon has got a double, a dash. We like dashes. We've got magic damage, and a double. It's not too bad. Got a couple of damage tokens and a surge. That surge was remove all of our shields. We haven't got any, so the surge is useless. That's good. The dash is useless, apart from the fact it's given the dragon initiative. So, what's the dragon going to do? Well, the dragon's going to put one of its damage tokens on its double. We're going to put one of our magic damage tokens on our double. Then it's going to spend all of its damage tokens, which is 3. So, we get 3 damage. And we're going to spend all of our damage tokens, which total to 3. So, the dragon's going to get 3 damage. And then he's just got a dash and a surge, which are useless. So we'll put those back in. And we'll go again. Right, another dash. That's good. Oh, we've got a 2. We've got a 2 surge. for mind meld. We've got a initiative and a magic damage, which is good. He's got an agility, a dash. He's got a surge. But that's okay because we don't have a shield and he's got a shield. But he has got two initiative. We've got two initiative. Woohoo! So we get to go first because we match. Right. So what have we got to do? Well, I think the main thing is straight off we spend this two surge for mind meld. So we've got mind meld. The dragon couldn't stop that, so he's got to be very careful now. So surge is useless, these two are useless, so he can flip, and I think he's going to have to use is he going to use that flip? Well, I don't think he is actually, because that'd flip a shield over, and that shield is stopping him getting this damage, essentially. So, he may as well... Can he may as well try... Oh, he can use it on these three, though. Yes, he can, can't he? He can. So, he's going to use his agility token, and he's going to flip this one onto a damage. Or is he? No, he's going to flip this one onto a double. I think. Because then he'll get to... No, he doesn't need two shields, does he? So, yeah, flip this one onto a damage. Alright, so he spends that. He's flipped that one onto a damage. So, we've got an agility. Do we want to try and flip that back? In fact, no, we'll use this. We don't want to flip that back. We want to flip this baby. So we're going to try and flip that. So we're going to make him recast. We're going to make him recast his shield. Oh, dropped it. Oh, every time I try and recast, I get exactly the same. Right, he's still got his shield. So, he's going to spend... Oh, God. He doesn't want to spend that now, does he? But, yeah, he's going to spend this. Yeah. And put one damage on. So, it's up to four. Mind meld, he's going to get a damage back. But he's going to use his shield. So that goes in here. So he prevented that going back. I think you can prevent mind meld going back. Yep, it's just magic damage. Yep, doesn't say anything that you can't block it. So it's managed to block it. And then it's Master Thorn's go. That is going to go through. So it is up to four. And the surge and the dash are no good. So they're both on four. And we go again. Right, so Master Thorn. Two damage and a double. We have... And we have two damage. We have a shield, a surge, a double. But nobody... Absolutely nobody got any initiative whatsoever. So it's Master Thorn to go first again. And he's going to spend... Yes. He's going to spend his double combat damage, which is two. Puts two on. He's only got one shield. Yeah. Only one shield, so he can only prevent one. And that means he's still at five, and the great dragon has been defeated. Brilliant stuff. So, good stuff there from Master Thorn. He's managed to defeat the dragon, but at the cost of four health, unfortunately. But he's killed the dragon. He gets to keep that as a trophy, which is very important because he now has four. So he only needs one more trophy to be able to learn Puppet Master. So Great Dragon is a trophy. He's also going to take a law as a reward. So he's up to three law. Excellent stuff. We'll put the dragon's damage back. So he's done really well. He's done really well, and he's got one action left. And as I put that combat trophy over there, guess what I saw? Saw a big sign with the word teleport on it, which is groovy. So even before he spends that action, he can teleport somewhere. So he's got two options. I think he can either go here to this quest, or he can go up here to this social adventure gem. I think we'll go up here, because up here we've got a few quests that are all bunched together. So if I manage to remember about my teleport every time I get one of those quests and get a trophy, then I should be able to zip between them. And really, he's going to have to do that now to catch up to Lyssa. He's going to have to get quite a few trophies, I think. So what he's going to do is he's going to go 1, 2, 3 and teleport here. In order to do that, he's going to have to spend trophies. And he's going to spend... Well, he may as well spend one of his body trophies, I think, because he can't learn body stuff. So he's got to exert, and he's going to exert brutality. Yep. So get rid of that. It's a body one anyway, so he can't use it. So he's used that, and he's now got over to here. Right, so he's over to there, and he's still got one action left. So what he's going to do is he's going to rest because he took four damage. I think it is, yes, it's a plains. So let's roll five dice and rest. Plains dice. Well, we've got three. We've got three plains dice there. So he's down. He's only got one damage now. So we can put this three back. So not a bad little turn there for Master Thorn. And I remember teleport. Woohoo! Even in the correct order and everything. Top banana. Right, let's go down and see how Lyssa's getting along. And here's Lyssa. What we're going to try and do with her is we're going to try and have Lyssa get to Mennara's, what is it? Mennara's teeth. So let's see if we can get her there. And that means rolling some dice. So we definitely need a wild or a mountains. Defo. Come on. Oh, we've got a wild. I think we've got enough. I think we've just done it. So let's have a quick look. Yeah. So there we are. What was it? Did you have it there? Should have been here. It was just north of Market Town. So she can use that. And she can use her wild. Fantastic. So we'll get her here into Mennara's teeth. Good stuff. What's she going to do? Is she going to do the quest? Or is she going to do the adventure gem? Let's just check Storm of Magic. Quest. Wild magic has been leaking out of Mennara's teeth, creating fantastic light storms that roll across the riverlands. The power it must hold. One action. Test spirit in Mennara's teeth. So if we get one success, that's it. We get struck by lightning. Two damage. If we get two successes, we channel the storm and gain one bonus trophy. But do you know what? We can't do any better than that because we've only got two spirit. So we can't speak with the storm spirit, and we might lose two damage. So what we'll do, yeah, because we're trying to get, we're trying to get mountains. So it would be mountains or wilds. So what we'll do is we'll leave this. We'll do the actual combat adventure gem first. We'll do that next turn, Storm of Magic. So let's use our last two actions, turn that over, and let's have a look at the combat deck. Ooh, an Orc Brigand. Warrior, humanoid, only 6 health. How can an Orc Brigand have more health than a Great Dragon? I don't know. Right, anyway, warrior, humanoid. This enemy may spend one surge to prevent its foe from flipping a token. Well, meh. Oh, 2 surges. That's nasty. Smash. Deal 3 damage. And the reward is to gain 2 gold. Okay. Right. So, put that down here. And let's get combating. So, 5 monster runes and 4. Remember, we've got 4 runes for Lyssa, because she's got the hunting spear. She does have the option to sort of throw this as sort of a ranged attack. As a combat action, you may remove the hunting spear token to test body plus 1, so that'd be 3. She'd test 3 cards, and for each success she'd deal a combat damage. But I think what we'll do is we'll just, it's only got 6 health, so we'll keep the hunting spear as a melee weapon for now. We won't actually cast it at the Orc Brigand. We'll just keep it. So we'll put that there. And if we keep it, obviously we get to keep the token, the rune. So there we go. And just cast them. See how we go on. Right, so a dash. We like that. Ooh, another dash, but it probably means it'll be going first. Damage, a surge, so it can prevent us from flipping anything over. We've got a shield, a damage, a surge, and an agility, and it's got a shield as well. But it's got two initiative. We're not going to be flipping any of those over, so they're used up. They don't do anything. But it does get to go first. The surge. Well, it wants to keep the surge because it probably wants us prevent us using this flip token. So, what's it going to do? Well, all it can do really is spend this. So it's going to spend its combat token, and we're obviously going to reply with a shield. So, net gain of nothing for anybody there. Then it's the monster again. And it's going to pass, because there's nothing it can do. We, on the other hand, are going to use our physical damage. It's going to reply with the shield. And then it's our go. And what are we going to do? Well, we're not going to bother using the flip anyway. We're going to use our surge. And we're going to use our surge. And that means we can use, I believe it's Stalk Prey. So let's Stalk Prey. Put that there. Knock everything out of the way. Why don't I? And right. The only problem with this is we need wilds or mountains, which aren't very common. Come on, Stalk Prey. Well, we got one. We got one in a wild, so we got 2. So that's 2 damage. Brilliant. A lot better than I was expecting. I thought we were pretty lucky just to get 1 damage. So we actually got 2 damage that it can't block. So that's a good start. So we'll get rid of that. And he's got a surge that he can't use, we've got a flip that we can't use, and we've got 2 dashes that can't be used, so we may as well get rid of those and save ourselves a bit of time. Right, let's go again. So, dash, another dash, and a flip, a magic damage, a physical damage, and a shield. And all important, 2 initiative. He's got a shield, he's got a damage, another surge. Right, but it's only got two initiative, so we will be going first. Again, it hasn't got a flip token, so those are now useless. We'll put those in the cup. Right, so what's the best way for Lyssa to go? Well, I think Lyssa is... See, we'd really like to flip that token, but it'll just stop us from doing it. So, and we may as well keep it anyway to stop that damage. So what we'll do is we'll just spend one magic damage. We would have put one damage, except he's got a shield, so he's going to spend a shield, so no net gain. Us again, we are going to spend this physical damage off the hunting spear. He cannot prevent that. So we'll go up to 3 damage. And it's his go. And he's going to spend his damage. And we're going to spend our shield. So no net damage. And then we've got a flip token and a surge token that can't be used. They're pretty much cancelling each other out. So we'll go into the next round of combat. Ooh, a surge, good. And magic damage. It's got a dash. Combat, a double token. We've got a agility and a shield. He's got another combat. And he has got a surge again, which stops us from flipping. But we get to go first. We've got initiative. So what to do? Well, he does not have any shields at all. So I think what we can do is we may be able to win this. We'll spend the surge first. So we're going to have a go again with Stalk Prey. See if I can do it this time without knocking everything everywhere. So again, we need mountains or wilds. Come on. One wild. Well, at least it's something. We're in with a chance. So that's one damage. We need two more. Now it's the Art Brigand's go. What's the Art Brigand going to do? Well, it might want to spend pretty quickly. I think it's going to put its surge onto the double. It's going to put its surge onto the double and see if it can do three damage. I think that's its best chance of getting a lot of damage onto us. Oh, no it isn't, is it really? It would be, but we've got two damage here that we can spend next turn. I think... Oh no, we haven't got two damage. That's a bloody flip token. Don't! Yep, so it is going to do that. It's going to double up its surge. It's us to go, and I think what we're going to do is we're obviously going to use this magic damage. So that's going to go in. Can't prevent it, goes up to 5. What the Ark's going to do is it's going to use its double surge. It's going to deal 3 damage, but we have got a shield, so it's only going to deal 2. So we take 2 damage. I think that's the best it could do. It's us to go. All we've got is an agility token, so we can't do anything. And then finally, it's going to put two more damage on us. So we're going to go up to 4 damage, unfortunately. Right, and we cast again. Right, so a surge. I'm sick of it getting surges. 2 of those. And that, and a shield, a damage and a shield. And we get a load of rubbish agilities that we can't really use. And we get a shield. And it's the monster to go first. It's got more gold. So what's it going to do? There's not much it can do, to be honest. All it can really do is spend this. spend that, and we're going to obviously block it with this. So no net damage anywhere. Then it's our go. We've pretty much got to spend this surge again. So let's hope that we manage to roll another wild. Not that dice tower. The other dice tower. A wild again or a mountain. Come on. Oh, a wild and two mountains. We've done it. So we got the final damage on. Even though he's got one of these, we got three damage. It's only stopped one. So we have managed to kill the Orc Brigand. So that's good news. So I'll put those back. Put her tokens back. Unfortunately, she's took another four damage. So she's now on five damage because she had one from previously. And she does get a trophy though. She does get the Orc Brigand as a trophy. And she gains two gold as a reward. So she's now got four trophies. She's got three combat trophies and a quest trophy. Don't think there's anything that she can... Let's just have a look at what she's got available to learn. So, sense of direction, she could learn that. Once per roll, you may re-roll up to X terrain dice. X is your might. So that'd be two terrain dice that she could re-roll. Might be useful. But it's once per turn. Stalwart, plus three health. She's got just enough for that. That could be useful as well. Or Ascendance. Now, she hasn't got quite enough for Ascendance, but that'd be one additional action to spend each turn. So what we'll do is we'll hold on for this. All she needs is... All she needs is a social trophy, and there's a social there. So I think we'll hold on for this. So she won't learn anything, but it's always good to check. Right, so that's it for her. She's done... She did a movement action and then she did that combat gem. So that is it for turn 12. And it's now act 2. So let's find out how we sort of do act 2 and what that entails. Right, so here we are, end of turn 12. So what do we do? Well, we take the first act marker, we flip it over, and we're now in act 2. And we go right back up the top here. So there we are, what is essentially turn 13. Right, anything else that we do? Well, this little fella comes out. Yes, Margath. And he goes to Sky Down. So he stays there for the whole of act 2. It's only at the end of act 2 that he will start moving up towards Tamalir. And if he gets to Tamalir, it's all over, man. But for the whole of Act 2, he's in Skydown. So if anybody wants to go and take him on, they just make their way to Skydown and initiate a combat with him. So that's pretty groovy. The bad thing that happens, well, apart from Margath coming out, is all enemies now get an extra combat rune. And it's a nasty one. There's a gold surge on one side, so not only an extra surge, extra initiative, and we've got an extra two possible damage on the other side. So that is bad news, particularly for Master Thorn, because he's rubbish at combat. Right, so that's pretty much it. So what we'll do is we'll crack on with turn 13, which is the first of Act 2. And that means we get back to Master Thorn, who's up near Exile Peak. And here's Master Thorn. Right, for his first... Well, for his sort of first couple of actions, he's gonna... Let's pop across this social trophy. We need this social trophy. He needs to get Puppet Master. At least give him a chance. So, there we go. First two actions, let's get the social deck. Get over. Oh, and we get a quest. Cult leader quest. The great Lord Merle has joined the Dread, a dangerous cult of dragon worshippers. So we can either spend one action or two actions in Kaer Loic. Where's that? Oh, it's not even far away. There it is. Woohoo! So if we spend one action, we listen to the Dread. Gain one law. If we have no law, well, we've got three, so that's useless. But if we spend two actions, we can foster rebellion. Gain one law and explore. If we do not roll a wild, we'll discard this card. But if we do roll a wild, we get to take it as a trophy. So not bad. So he's got a quest of cult leader. And added bonus, it's not too far away. So he keeps that. He doesn't get it as a trophy though yet, which is unfortunate. So it's sort of a quest at the moment. He has to complete that quest and do that roll in order to get it as a trophy. So that's unfortunate. It means he cannot learn Puppet Master yet, which is a bit of a downer. Right, he has got one action left. The other thing as well, because he didn't get it as a trophy, he can't teleport either, which is a bit of a downer. So is he going to move? Yep, I think he'll move. And, oh, the other thing we've got to do, obviously, is we'll put a little marker up here so we know he's got a quest there. Right. Let's roll that. Well, he's got two mountains and a plains. So what's he going to do? What is he going to do? Well, he can't really get anywhere else. But he can use a mountain for Exile Peak, and he can use a plains to get there. So he's right next to Kaer Loic. So we'll try that. And that is it for his actions. He spent two to flip over the social adventure gem, and he spent one to move there. Right, so that is it for Master Thorn. So let's see what Lyssa's going to do. And here's Lyssa. She's in Mennara's teeth. We've got a quest here, so let's have a look at it. It is Storm of Magic. We had a quick look a bit ago. So we've got to spend one action, and we have got to explore by the look of it. Oh no, test spirit. So our spirit is two. So we get to draw two skill cards, and we're looking for two successes. Skill cards, where are you? And here are the skill cards. But we have got Lady Luck, and we are testing an attribute. So cultural immersion, that's a success. We need another success. Racketeering, another success. Brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. We get two successes. There's no need for us to use Lady Luck, because two successes is the best we can get. So we channel the storm, gain one bonus trophy. So we get this as a trophy. So she's now got five trophies. And we gain a bonus trophy. Can we pick? Can we pick? It doesn't say which type of trophy. So I think we get to pick. So if we're going to pick, we're going to pick a social trophy, man. So we're up to six. He's got three combat trophies, two quest trophies, and a social trophy. We can discard those. And woohoo! She's in the middle of her actions, so we can't learn a skill yet, but she will be learning a skill. Right, she's going to, what's she going to do with the second action? Get rid of that now. She is going to, well, she may as well move. So let's move. No particular reason to get to this social trophy now, because we got a bonus trophy, and I think you can pick what type of trophy you get. So let's move this way. We'll try and get over towards where the collector is on the greenwood. So that's three movement dice. Oh, damn. Oh, thank God we got the wild. Right. So, the wild allows us to do... Well, it's rubbish, really. We'll keep the wild. And... Because the wild gets us out to here. So, then... We will exert, I think, for one more dice. We'll use Stalwart. Let's see if we can get anywhere else. And we've got a Plains, so that'll allow us to move here. And not going to exert anymore. So at least we've got onto the Plains. Right. And moved a bit, and she's got one action left now. So yeah, she did that for one action, she moved for one action, and she's going to move again for her final action. Hang on, let's just move the camera slightly. We can see where she's trying to get to now, so she's trying to get over here. And two wilds and a Plains, I think, will be good enough. So she's going to use the Plains to go here, and it'd be another Plains to there. In fact, she's going to go all the way across. She's going to go all the way across to where the collector is, ready for next turn, I think. I think she's got to actually spend... Yeah, we need one action. We need to spend one action over there, so we can't do it this turn. But that is the end of her actions, and she can learn. She can learn a skill, and if you remember, we've got Ascendance. So we need one of each colour, plus two others, so five in total, and you have one additional action to spend each turn. This is immense. So she's going to learn that. So one of each colour. Those three, and she's going to spend two others. Just seeing what else she's got left. She's got sense of direction. No, that's all right. So she'll spend one combat and one quest. So that's five cards in total, at least one of each. And she has now learned Ascendance. I'll just put these back in the discard piles. Cool. So she's had another excellent turn. And that's the end of turn 13. Right, let's have a look at the whole board and have a quick recap. And here we are, back at Terranoth. Okay, so how have we done? Not too bad. Master Thorn's done okay. He managed to kill the Great Dragon at Blackwing Swamp. Then he got another quest up here, just by Exile Peak, and he's making his way towards that. Although he's done quite well, he's not got many trophies, he's got quite a few lore, but he's appalling at combat, man. He is appalling. His mind meld ability is pretty much useless if you do not get initiative, and he hasn't got enough initiative, so we're going to have to think up something there. But other than that, he did quite well. But that, it's comparing him to Lyssa, who's just on fire, man. Here she is, down here. She made her way to Mennara's Teeth, she killed the Orc Brigand, then she solved the mystery of Mennara's Teeth, so she got another, she got a quest trophy, and she also got a bonus trophy, so she picked a social one. Then she moved all the way across here, so she's ready to deal with the Collector, the story quest, so hopefully she'll do that next turn. And she was able to learn Ascendance. And the good thing about Ascendance is it gives her an extra action to spend each turn. So she is absolutely immense. And she could take her time. I mean, even if this was a two-player game, if I was playing Lyssa, I wouldn't be worried about Master Thorn at all. I'd say, you try and get to Margath first, mate. Knock yourself out, I'd be telling him. So it's pretty much hers to lose as it stands. She's doing fantastically well. Right, so, any other things of note? Yes, we're in the second act, So all the monsters now have that extra combat. Well, that extra, extra combat token, I suppose you'd call it. The combat rune. So they're all a bit harder to defeat, which is even worse news for Master Thorn, who's lagging behind badly. All his eggs are in the getting the puppet master skill basket as it stands. But at least he's remembering to teleport. So that's it for episode 6 of Runebound 3rd edition, The Ascendance of Margath. Thanks very much for watching. Thanks very much for all the subscriptions and all the comments and all the tips and all the help. Very much appreciated. Which reminds me, the channel is now on at Board Game Links. It's like a big list of websites and stuff, and you can upvote your favourites. So, you know, if you were sort of wandering across that way and didn't have anything else better to do, perhaps press that button and update the channel for me. That'd be much appreciated. Thank you. How's that for a bit of grovelling? I'll put the link somewhere. So you can bob along, and only if you want to, of course, just give me a quick upvote. Just basically so I'm not last. Thank you very much. Right, so that bit of grovelling done. I hope you join me next time for episode 7 of Runebound 3rd edition, The Ascendance of Margath. But until then, this is me, Catweazle, signing off. Toodaloo.